see you. Well, now I have more stuff to sell. There's another thing here. The restroom. Might as well check that out. And surprisingly, nothing in here. Okay. If I'd have known, I would have waited. So this goes back down. Yeah, I remember going past this. Like giant bullets. Oh wow. We completely bypassed this. Sorry guys, I just want to go in order. This is back the first floor. I'm not sure if there's anything down here. We went in here, but we didn't get far. Did we? Maybe not. Like a bar. Did she kill the ones in here too? It happens so fast, you know. Huh. Well, if you want alcohol, here's a place to be. PAM override code. Yeah, there's another way to do it. These damn tech support slackwits. When we barred the door to HR and accounting and made them use the stairwell, they would not stop whining about it. But at every turn, they proved me right about it. Nosy little beeps are always up to some kind of humbuggery. And the automechanical specialist that's in charge of PAM is the worst one. He's always changing some setting or another for routine repairs, and then, after all hell breaks loose, it's up to me and my security team to pick up the pieces. That's pretty hard to do, considering half of my team has paws instead of hands. Canids are easier to manage, they said. They're more resource efficient, they said. Top rungers, and everyone wonders why I'm always drinking in the lounge. Anyway, this guy changed Pam's combat override code again, without telling me. Again. I don't think Pam Blam, thank you ma'am, A2368 fit security guidelines, but screw it. At least this time, it's not about another employee's mother. Okay, so if we hadn't found the battery, we could have just said that to Pam and she would have overridden the guidelines and went into combat anyway. Pretty cool. But both are really easy to find. You just have to go in the room that they're in. Alright, so I meant to go here, but instead went here. And it's not... I thought it was some kind of auditorium, meeting room. It's a bar. Current user R. Hyde. Reception messages. From M. Eliason. Subject, lost my ID. Rosemary. Hey, sorry to bother you, but I lost my ID. Don't know how it happened. I have a very strict system for organizing my desk. Someone probably took it. Can you deactivate it and get me a new one? Thanks, Minoru Eliason. To Michael Liu. Subject, screen fife? Hey, Rosemary. From Hyde. To Lou. Mike. Wait. That's messed up. It should be from Michael Liu to R. Hyde. Hey, Rosemary, you seen Fife around? Pam's old battery is having trouble holding a charge, and all my spares keep disappearing. You know how it goes around here. If something's disappearing, Fife probably swiped it and put it in the facilities office like a trophy. Since your desk in the lobby isn't too far from the facilities, I was hoping you might have spotted him on his way in or something. If you do, tell him Mike Liu has 3 packs of Spacer's Corona ready to trade, or to trade for the industrial strength Firefly battery that disappeared last week. I'd appreciate it. Interesting. So that... Oh, it's water. Sealed. Some doors there. Show your boss that you are prime. Stairs up to upper levels. Okay, these offices. Oops. I don't think we checked all the rooms here. Yeah, we found the battery and just went to town. That's barred. And this goes where? To a separate room. I guess we dropped down or something? How would we unbar that, right? Storeroom. Gravedigger. Okay. Well, that's interesting. Hopefully I get to go in there. Otherwise I'll probably forget about it anyway. Gravedigger. Dig your enemy's grave, then put him in it. Too funny. None of these doors are real. Then why put this here? Okay. So there's two stairways. Oh, but that way is barred. So we can come back down that way then. Okay, so now we can finish fighting the baddies on this level. Still in the middle of the stairwell. Okay. I guess that's the floor that's not in use. HR and accounting. Okay, so we've cleared. This is cleared out. And this is cleared out. And I think this... So the only thing left on this floor is this room. And then we got stairs. So that's cool. Did I just switch? Yeah. Oh, it's barred. We have to go through here, we have to go through that door. Okay. Let's go sell a few more things since we're here. Hope doesn't bother you guys. Just do it to keep myself from being overweight. Because we are picking up a lot of things. A lot of heavy things. Weird noise come back. You're kidding me. It has a 150 lock. How do we get in then? How do we get up? There's gotta be another way. Let me see if I can do it. The stairwell, I think, goes up more. I'm not sure. But I do want to get in there. They got sealed on one side and come, like, really expertly locked on this side. Lockpick plus 10 for Safecracker's jacket. Lockpick plus 5 for the padded helm. Anything even better? Okay. So that puts me at... Wait. 142. So if I take... something... Is it mind attributes that helps? Yeah, we were a cashier. It's gonna be dexterity, maybe? Body attributes. Lockpick. Okay, so it's a body attribute. Body attributes. Plus one. +146. Wait, if I get in here, and then here, right? Wait. Yeah. There are actually three ways in. So then we have to go through here, actually. Alright. I didn't spot that. This is a little room at the end, too.
Nicely done.
Okay. Electromagnetic flash lens. 201 bits, okay. Okay. I forgot too. I didn't realize that was the same room. That's the way in there. And looks like the way up beyond them. Ready? I'm back. Not all the way, isn't. Wait, here's a third coming up.
Smooth.
They didn't even notice. Terminal over there. Oh, I saw you over there before.
Gonna find you.
Mess with us.
You found me. Now what? See another one moving up. Maybe not actually in this room, but in there. I'd rather take care of that one. Disappeared. I like this theme. Showing up again and then disappearing. I mean, that's... We've been in there. Let's check over here, and then we'll go back to the terminals. Well, I don't think this is anything we can get into. Must be up? I'm not sure. Still can't unlock that even from the other side. Yeah, I've killed all the ones in there. Alright, never mind then. Probably upstairs. Department, Human Resources. Current user, K. Blomstead. Messages. To C. Norwood, subject employee exchange. From Human Resources. Spacer's Choice is aware of Dr. Lowe's eccentric habits. Yes, Dr. Lowe medicates himself with experimental drugs of his own design. No, we have not mentioned this flaw in Dr. Lowe's character in our exchange contract with Anti-Cleo. We believe that Dr. Lowe's behavior is consistent with the values of our rival company. Dr. Lowe and Anti-Cleo are, in the opinion of Spacer's Choice, an ideal match. Both Dr. Lowe and the Anti-Cleo company believe themselves to be better than nature. That is Anti-Cleo's slogan. Please be informed that Anti-Cleo has generously offered at least 3 senior personnel in exchange for Dr. Lowe. It is Spacer's Choice company policy to accept any bargain in our favor. Sincerely, K. Blomstead, Senior Regional Vice Manager, Human Resources. And so this is how Dr. Lowe went from Spacer's Choice to Anti-Cleo. To Michael Liu, subject semantic hygiene. Oh, more using bad words. Bad choice of words or something like that. Michael, the office has reviewed your report of unlawful behavior exhibited by certain colleagues at your designated workplace. We find the contents of your report alarming and inconsistent with the values and vision of the Spacer's Choice family. While it is the duty of every member of our family to report seditious and unlawful behavior, it is important to express your report using appropriate company-approved language. Hold on 1 second, guys. Your description of violent outbursts and aggressive behavior from your colleagues is problematic. Furthermore, the office disapproves of your obvious exaggerations of any physical injuries sustained in your alleged altercations with your colleagues. How dare you say things as they really are? Okay, so nothing else over there, but we've got a terminal here. Current user C. Norwood. From A. Metcalf. Subject re printer broken. Printer broken question mark. It's not broken, it's just out of paper, which I have to say is pretty damn amazing. How in the name of the grand plan did you manage to print 450 documents in a week? Those can't all be transfer requests, can they? I know this project is well funded, but the head researcher must be even more famous than I thought if we're getting this many. Best, Aaron. Okay, so it's an Aaron Metcalf. From K. Blomstead, across the room. Subject, last warning. Colin, you know our policy. Even if you do have proof that Mr. Putnam has been taking your lunch, Spacer's Choice disciplinary guidelines for theft only apply to Spacer's Choice property. You, your lunch, and Mr. Putnam will constitute Spacer's Choice property. It is legally impossible for property to steal from itself. That's so stupid. What the hell? Please note that an inability to protect your own source of nourishment will be reflected on your permanent record. Okay, so you get disciplined when someone else steals your lunch. Nice. You guys are the ultimate bullies. If you cannot be trusted to guard your own sandwich, you cannot be trusted to guard classified information on behalf of Spacer's Choice. Oh, nice. Karen Blomstead, Senior Regional Vice Manager of Human Resources. P.S. Please have those reports sorted and on my desk before lunch. You're not in a junior position anymore, Colin. Somehow I still don't think it was an improvement, getting up from a junior position. Okay, so this is the way out, then. We've completed this floor. With the help of Pam. Wow.
Watch your hands, Captain. Be a bad time to lose them. Well, I guess any time to be a bad time, but especially now.
I'm not gonna touch the vats of whatever this is. Don't worry. And we're up. Said there were floors going down too, but I didn't don't think I find any floors down. Not yet, anyway. Is it really that close, or is 83? It's the way up. I did have a red blip, but it's gone. Oh, I see you. Oh, I keep walking out of. Oh, heads up, guys. He's gonna walk back, isn't he?
Hmm.